environment in this beach is really crazy. If you're a moto fan, if you love driving, you must visit this beach.
If you have an off-roading jeep or car, even the car. Please try to avoid National Highway 66 if you have to go to Kochi, take a flight.
Hi guys, good morning, and today we are in God's own country, Kerala. We planned to leave around 5 a.m. but Tej was not well, so we left around 6:30 a.m. and now we are somewhere Neeleshwaram? No, it is Neeleshwaram. St. Anglo Fort in Kannur. So let's go inside and check this amazing historical fort.
In the entrance of the fort, you will find this board with QR code in it. You have to scan this code using smartphone and follow the instructions. This will generate the entry pass and it costs 20 rupees per person.
Even though videography was allowed inside the fort, we were told we cannot vlog inside the fort. It was little weird. The fort was huge and clean. Story goes like this. During Vasco da Gama's visit to India, the local Kolathiri king granted the land to build a settlement in Kerala. Portuguese King Francisco built this triangular shaped fort in 1505. Then the fort was taken over by the British in 1790 and was turned into their main army center in Malabar region. The fort had lot of abandoned cannons, and we could picturize how this would look when it was active. Sorry for my pronunciation, I really can't pronounce this word. This is a drive-through beach. It's in Kerala. It's somewhere between Kannur and Thalassery. And this is one of the longest drive-through beach in Asia. How amazing it is. You can see all the cars driving.
If you have an off-roading jeep or car, even the car. I miss my bike. I should have brought my bike here. Instead of coming in car, you can ride any kind of vehicle here. You can see Activas also here. So any kind of vehicle you have, you can come here, you can drive. The entry is 40 rupees per car. I think it is 20 rupees per bike. I mean, that is two-wheeler. This is one of a kind experience.
So the environment in this beach is really crazy. If you are a moto fan, if you love driving, you must visit this beach. We have heard a lot about this place. There are really good ratings in Google, so we came to this restaurant. So this is Paris' old restaurant. There's one new restaurant also, the AC restaurant, but this is a traditional old restaurant which doesn't have any AC. It has very old architecture, I can say. The hot water is served, that is the best part, and there's no parking also over here. I think in the new restaurant they have parking facility, and the menu, they said they have chicken biryani, mutton biryani, ghee rice, some chicken fry. We'll be right back. in Bangalore as well. So there is difference in the taste, vast difference, because this is the local biryani which is famous over here and you must try it. I do recommend this. And I'm not sure with the price. Once we get the bill, we'll get to know the price. But as of now, the taste is really good with raita and the pickle.
Even the mutton biryani is good. Taste is really good. Mutton is not that tender, but it's good. The taste wise is good. And it's like authentic that Kerala biryani which you get. The bridge, see how this bus people come. I mean, they have blocked the coming traffic, and this is a national highway. How can you expect to reach on time? What is the Sava? Yeah. See, they have blocked all one-way traffic. We have come around 250 kilometers. There is still 160 kilometers to go. I mean, this national highway 66 is horrible. Like, literally, it's not at all like national highway. Like, when you picturize highway, you see four-lane roads, all those things. But this is just two-lane throughout. Entire national highway 66 is a city, small city. So you'll find lorries, buses, and rickshaw people. It is horrible experience. Huh? Please try to avoid. National Highway 66, if you have to go to Kochi, take a flight, I would suggest. Or if you have 2-3 drivers, or if you have a bike, then I think it will be a little better. You hear that? We are in Fort Kochi.
I have something very important to tell this time.
Yeah, we have a new resolution.
It's a really exciting one for us personally because we love traveling. We have started traveling rigorously from past 6 months, I think. So this year our resolution is we must visit at least 10 different states in India.
This is our one state.
Yeah.
Tomorrow or maybe day after tomorrow we are going to one more state.
Yes.
Keep watching.
You'll get to know everything slowly. So if you have any recommendation about which states we should cover, please drop some comment and give us a better idea about how we can plan our trip.
And please tell how the road is, and how people drive videos.
Yeah, if it is somewhere close by in South India, we will definitely take a road trip. Otherwise, we will think about it.
The main motto of taking this challenge or setting this goal is to let you guys know that this is possible. So if you have a 9-to-5 job and if you love traveling and you are on a budget,
Yes,
then please do subscribe to our channel and
because
watch our all videos.
Trips will be only a budget trip, but definitely.
Yes, and we will give you all the information. How did we travel? And how you can save money and where and all you can stay. See you guys in next video.
Until then, bye. Stay safe and travel.